Today we are going to be talking about the carbon footprint of a building. Before I start talking about the carbon footprint of a building, we will talk about the greenhouse gas effect. What is a greenhouse gas effect? There is radiation from sun that comes to our earth practically every second of the day. Now, some of this radiation is reflected back by the surface of the earth. Some of it is absorbed by the earth, and therefore the earth's temperature gets increased, and a part of the reflection gets absorbed by the gases, this beautiful 20 kilometer air atmosphere that we are surrounded by. It absorbs the heat and it is supposed to dissipate that heat, but unfortunately some of those gases consume this heat or stores this heat and increases the atmospheric temperature, and that, my friend, increases the overall temperature of the earth. And that, how does it happen? One of the reasons why it happens is because of the buildings. Buildings alone are responsible for 38% of the greenhouse gases that are there out there in the atmosphere. A building goes through certain life cycle transformations. First there is land, and then it gets converted into some kind of a foundation, footings and columns and then beams, and then, you know, the roofs, the walls, the finishes, and people start using them, and over a period of time they age, just like human beings do or any other life form does. The buildings age and it comes to an end of its life, and they get demolished and gets converted into something else, whatever it may be. It could be, it just could become a waste material, it could be recycled, it could be reused, it could be deconstructed, as the case may be, and part by part some of those parts could be used in some other building or in some other system. Now, there is carbon emission in each of those processes. If you look at the carbon emissions that will be there, first, extraction. There is, let's take iron ore, let's take cement, let us take any other material that goes into a building. Obviously, most of these materials come from earth's resources. So you take the earth resources and extract them. And in the process, there is energy that is being consumed. Now, what's wrong with this energy? I'll come to that in a second. Now, after extracting, these need to be manufactured, these need to be converted. For instance, iron ore needs to become steel or iron rods, or you take aluminium again, you know, the ore needs to be converted into aluminium, and so on and so forth. And then these finished products in the manufacturing area need to be transported to the construction area, wherever your buildings are getting constructed. And then there is construction process. You know, take for instance an iron rod that needs to come to the building, it needs to be welded together. The welding requires energy once again. It could be, another example could be tiles. You know, once you put it there, you need to polish them. Some of these tiles require polishing, and that requires energy, of course. Then there is maintenance, and then there is refurbishment, there is demolition energy, there is recycling energy. In every part there is energy that is being used. Now, this energy, where does it come from? In India, more than 85% of the energy that we use comes from coal energy. Now, what's wrong with coal energy? 1 ton of coal that we burn produces 1 ton of carbon emissions. It emits 1 ton of carbon into the atmosphere. You take cement, 1 meter cube of concrete, which is a combination of cement and a few other admixtures that go into making this concrete, produces about 1 ton of carbon dioxide. Now, Earth, as I just told you, is a simple trapped system which has to consume this carbon in such a way that there is enough of balance of carbon and oxygen for us to survive in this planet. Now, there are 2 basic carbon sinks that are naturally given to us by Mother Nature. One is the oceans, the other one is the tree cover or the forest cover that we have. but you know what's happening to both of them, right? So we are losing the tree cover in huge quantity, huge rate every day, and the carbon emissions that can be absorbed by the oceans are already gone beyond the ocean's ability to absorb. So we are about 130%, 140% of that of the capacity of the ocean's ability to convert carbon and consume it and, you know, make the ecological balance sustain itself. So what could be the answer? Clearly, being in the real estate sector, Brick Eagle, we understand that we need to produce, we need to construct low carbon buildings around the world. So here are some examples that inspires us. There is this Aldo Leopold Foundation headquarters in Fairfield, USA. It's a low carbon footprint building. There are beautiful solar panels that are there on the rooftop. It does not require any air conditioning whatsoever during the summer season, and it does not definitely require much of heating during the winter season. And there is this Croon Hall in Yale University Environmental Studies, which are basically based on solar passive architecture, passive solar architecture, which brings in maximum sunlight during the day and traps as much heat as necessary during winter season within the building, so that you don't need heating equipments. It also creates enough ventilation for the air to circulate, and there is no need for air conditioning during the summer season as well. There is another building that really inspires us. It's Sustainable Energy Technology Center at the University of Nottingham. Beautiful building. Once again, it's been constructed based on the sustainable architecture principles. There are many such buildings I can go on talking about. You can look at some of the building low carbon building standards at lcbmethod.com. lcbmethod.com. Now, building is believed to have achieved its carbon neutrality if the total carbon emissions, just like I told you about, from cradle to grave, it is able to create that neutrality, if it is able to offset by use of green, you know, green cover, landscape architecture, maybe even, you know, go and compensate for these carbon emissions by creating a mini forestry somewhere else nearby your site, if you can, or wherever it's possible, you can definitely offset these carbon emissions. And while you have done so, if your total carbon emissions is less than or equal to zero, then we would say that it is a carbon neutral building. Brick Eagle, we dream to build carbon neutral buildings. We are very close, I would say, to where we were, to where we are today, and where we want to achieve. We're very close to achieving carbon neutrality. Our buildings have, we know based on the internal audit that we have done, we are about 50 to 60% less on carbon emissions today than what we were about 5 years ago or 4 years ago or even about 3 years ago in our buildings. And I'm happy to share with you that this number is going to continue to get better going forward, and our dream is to reach a carbon neutrality very soon. If you have any questions, do write a mail to me to Murali, M-U-R-A-L-I at brickeagle.com. I'm a co-founder of IDEAN Lab, which is the think tank behind driving in sustainability in Brick Eagle. Thank you very much.